right? Whether it's from your friends pushing you to do something you're afraid of, or bullies sending you rolling down a long green hill. We've all been there. My big push? Well, that's fifth grade, I'm 11, but it's getting a little ahead of myself. Why don't we start with the first big push? Ah! Ah! Holy shit! August 27th, 1999. 6:30. Now, as you can see, my mom was pretty happy to get me out of there.
Oh, look at him. He's just the tiniest little thing. Oh, I'm gonna name you Nathaniel. Oh, you look just like me.
Then there was my father, Wayne. Hand him here, you ain't. Let's see the next hockey star. Oh, he's gonna be a goalie. Oh, he smells funny. Now, my mom was the town hairdresser in Sunridge where I grew up. It's near North Bay. She moved to Ontario from Newfoundland when she was in her 20s to get away from the insanity that was Newfoundland. Six brothers, three sisters. Family reunions? Whew! Insane. But in a good way. And my dad, well, he's from Sarnia. And when he was my age, he was a jock. Yep! He rode motorcycles, played hockey, and he had aspirations to be in the army, but busted his knee playing a game the night before his physical. So instead, he decided to drive trucks, travel the country and beyond. Oh, I also had a sister. Not the most supportive person in the world.
Oh, he's so cute.
I'm gonna join so many judo and karate clubs and use you as a punching bag. We're gonna have so much fun. Needless to say, we fought a lot. But for the most part, life was just weird. Mom, why can't I go out? I'm not driving out in the middle of nowhere to pick your drunk ass up at 3 in the morning. Well, fuck you! There they go again. They're always fighting. It's never a dull moment. You see, at this point, my sister was getting ready to leave the 8th grade and head into high school. It's never an easy time, but they fought 24/7, and it was always about nothing. You know, stains on clothes, dog poop on the ground. One time they fought over who got the roundest roll at dinner. Now that one was intense. You see, when my mom gets mad, she gets mad. Like, mad. So, whenever they fought, I'd run up to my room, lock the door, put the TV on full, and ignore everything. By the time I was 15, I had over 300 DVDs. You see, my dad got a job working out west a few weeks after I was born. Better pay. I only got to see him for a few days every month. Sure, we talked on the phone a lot, but it was just different. You see, as I was growing up, I developed what you might call an overactive imagination. It's morphin' time! I will defeat you, Power Rangers! No, you won't! Tyrannosaurus! Ladies? Yeah, now that you've gotten to see that, why don't we skip ahead a little bit? Fifth grade, I'm 11. Now, at this point, due to my lack of social interaction and complete isolation at home, I was an easy target for bullies. See, I was always pegged as the spaz, the nervous geek, the weirdo. By the time I'd gotten to fifth grade, I'd already been to 3 schools. This one was about to be my 4th. I started at a place in a French immersion program called Land of Lakes. That's right, worst year of my life was spent at a place called LOL. Ironic, huh? So, first day of school, I introduced myself. Hi, I'm Nathan. I like superheroes, Weird Al, cartoons, oh, and wrestling!
You're weird.
Wrestling? That's gay. Yeah, totally gay. Good one, Kyle. What's so gay about it? Shirtless dudes rolling around on the floor hugging each other? Huh, totally gay.
Nice.
But it's more than that. They do rolls, flips, jumps. Oh, and John Cena's there, and he's all like, "You can't see me." And then he hits the guy. It's awesome. Oh, we're gonna have so much fun. So from that day forward, my nickname was John Cena. Creative, right? Of course, they got to know me more. There were other nicknames. Fatty McPhee, Little Bitch. Okay. It's 2011, Christmas time. I'm getting my bag from my locker, when all of a sudden, I felt a big push. Hey! What are you doing? We'll come get you in an hour, power faggot! No! No! Help! But help wasn't coming. Between the crowds of screaming kids and teachers scrambling, my yells were muffled hums. So there I was. Trapped, alone, claustrophobic. Me, myself, and I. Well, mostly. Help! Please! Well, I hate to break it to you, pal. Nobody's gonna be helping you today. Who said that? Is that Jim Carrey?
It's nobody, Nathaniel. It's just us. The voices inside your head.
John Lennon?
You've been in such a pain and depression state that we are now here to talk to you.
Alan Rickman, what the hell? Where are you all coming from?
Darling, it's me, Tim Curry from Rocky Horror. Listen, the people from the movies you watch, darling.
What?
Rob Williams here. You are so alone.
At this tender time in your life, you feel that we're the only people you can talk to.
I call you friends.
This doesn't feel normal.
Me, Rickman.
Listen, it's not
normal. But who wants to be normal?
Who cares about normal?
Yeah.
Think of me, Christopher Walken. Listen, I was in Pulp Fiction, Batman Returns, and Hairspray the Musical.
So, what's on your mind, champ? Clearly we wouldn't be here unless you had something on your mind.
Go on, dog.
Okay. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Every morning I get up and I come to school and I try really hard to be nice to everybody. But when I say anything, they just twist it and they throw it back in my face. They beat me up, they force my head into toilets, they throw me down hills, and now this. I'm stuck in my locker and it's really dark in here. And then when I go home, it's even worse. My mom, she yells all the time. She misses my dad, and my sister just yells at her and makes it worse. And they yell so much. I cry myself to sleep because I don't know how to be normal for 1 minute.
Daniel, all you need is love. You can never let anybody change you and tell you who you are as a person.
Look at me, Robin Williams. I'm a working guy with a million voices in my head. And I never let people stop me from being the best.
You're young, darling. So young still. It's not always going to be easy, but it'll get better.
Remember, kid,
you are you. You never let anyone change that.
Thanks. But, where's my dad? Why isn't he here to tell me all of this?
I'm right here, bud. I know I can't always be there in person to tell you I love you and everything's gonna be okay, but I love you. Everything's gonna be all right. You're one in a million, bud, and I'm always gonna be with you and proud of you. Everything you do in your life, I'm always right there. I'm right behind you.
Really? Thanks, Dad.
I can do this.
I got out about an hour later, and I took a deep breath instead of being angry. See, I was never going to be the person they were trying to beat me into being when I hadn't even been myself yet. You know, my mom always said, Nathan, when I'm feeling angry and I yell sometimes, music makes the bad feelings go away. So, I asked my mom for a guitar. She was a singer when she was younger, so she was really excited that I wanted to learn more. But I didn't just limit myself to that. You see, well, that might have been the worst year of my entire life. It was that summer that I discovered who I was. I'm a performer.
Whoa! Thanks, Mom!
mine. Nope. That's it. Okay. See? Nope. And G.
Wish you would step back from that ledge, my friend. You could cut ties with all the lies that you've been living in. And if you never want to see me again, I would understand. I would understand. I would understand. Eventually the nickname stopped. John Cena still stuck, but he's awesome, so I don't care. Eventually, I found myself going out for things. I joined student council, drama club, and I hosted every single pep rally and school event that I could. Eventually, I got to know everyone in my high school, and including the bullies from that story before. You know, it turns out a lot of them had really bad home lives. They were just kind of taking it out on me. In the 11th grade at a party, I had a chugging contest with that dick who shoved me in the locker, and I won. Now, I kind of like to think I won the whole thing. Sure, I'm still a little weird and have way too much free time on my hands, but that's okay. See, I think that's the thing about growing up. While at one point I was ready to take a different kind of big push and end everything, I realized I still had a lot left to do. So the tale ends on a high note. Oh, and my family. Well, when I was in the 8th grade, my dad got a better schedule. He was home for a few extra days every month. It wasn't a big difference, but my mom was happier. She felt like she wasn't raising us alone anymore, and I was just happy to have my dad back. When I was 16, him and I took a road trip together. We were heading to Sandusky, Ohio, the roller coaster capital of the world. All right, Nate, we're on the road again. Want to head up to Cleveland? Got a nice view of the lake over there. You know, I drove through here once when I was driving back in the day, and I was gonna take y'all here, but well, I was busy. I'm sorry, bud. You know, I know while I was out working and driving, well, what those boys did to you wasn't fair. You know, if I had the chance, I'd kill them. But that wouldn't solve anything. I'm proud of you, bud. Even though you went through hell, you came back swinging. This is fun, huh? Make up for some lost time. Hey, want to hear the greatest song of all time?
Yeah, Dad!
Okay. Well, this is called Bat Out of Hell. Coming from a guy, he's had an incredible journey getting here. He's been